I'm Ryan Sutton, and welcome to Inside Games. Today we'll be taking a look at CGE's game, Codenames. See you at the table. Codenames is a really fun game that we pretty much bring out to the table every time we have a game day. It's really easy to teach, super fun to play, plays very quick so you can get several games out, and we've had people of all ages over, and it seems to be pretty easy to pick up. So we're going to do a playthrough a little bit later on today. I've got some friends coming over, but before we get into that, I'm going to take you to the table and do a quick rules explanation before we get going. In Codenames, two teams are trying to be the first to see who can reveal their agents in the field. Each team will consist of one spy master, they're the clue giver, and their field operatives, the people guessing. So the clue giver, the spy master, will be looking at this key here is a representation of this 5x5 board. So this red here would be spider. This blue at the end here would be lock. So they're taking a look at this on both sides of the team. The spy masters are trying to figure out what one word clue they can give to reveal their colored agent on the board. Now there are tan areas, which are innocent civilians. So if you guess those, you would stop your turn immediately and the next team would get to guess. If you guess one of yours, let's say for instance, the spy master were to say bus one, and the blue team could get to school for school bus, they would place that there and they would get to keep guessing. Typically it's one over what the number was when they were doing the guess. But what you want to try to do is you want to be able to try to find a word that can give you clues to more than one card. So the blue team, for another example, could say door, and they could try to be pointing towards door bell and door lock. So as their field operatives will try to pick, they could go to bell for doorbell. We would place that there, and they could touch this for door lock, and we would place that there. So in doing that, it's going to give you a lot better chance of winning the game. So we know about actually putting these down and giving the one-word clues. At the end, when they give that one-word clue, like I said, bus for school, they get to say a number at the end. And the number is what you're trying to do to tie other cards in for multiple picks. So when I would say bus, I would say one because there's nothing else out there that I can think of that would bring two things together or more for bus. So that's why bus one would be school. For doorbell and door lock, me trying to put those together, I would say door, and then I would just say two, showing the field operatives that I wanted to actually get them to guess two things. Now you can guess more than one. Let's say for instance, on door, you guessed bell, and we placed that there. And then for some crazy reason, they went to chair. That wasn't theirs, their turn ends. Well, they know that there's another clue for door out there, so they can save that for the next round to then maybe do lock and then get the blue. And then last but not least, when you're placing cards on this sheet here, you would not want to give any clues that would result in this black section here. So I would not want to do anything that would allow them to pick press, because press is the assassin. If someone picks the assassin, the game immediately ends and the other team wins. One of the hardest things to do, especially if you're playing with new people that are going to be the spy master, being able to look at this at the beginning is very daunting because you have to look at every word. You need to pay attention to both teams' cards, the spy, things like that, to make sure that you're not picking the wrong cards. And also when you're the spy master, when you're giving your one word clue, there can't be any inflections in your voice. You can't start by saying, this is a stretch, but I'm gonna go with this. Or if they do pick something and by some crazy chance they actually still find one of your teammates, you can't say anything like, oh, that's not the one I picked, but good job anyways. So it's very hard on your first few games to actually not do those things. But it makes for good laughs at the table. And as the clue giver, you can't do anything crazy like make something rhyme, allude to corners on the board, allude to something with the number that you're using, like 8, for instance, for maybe octopus. So as I said before, my friends are going to be coming over and we're going to play a live playthrough of Codenames. Man, you know what? I kind of feel like we should do something a little bit different. This is my first video on my channel. Kind of need something different. I feel like there's playthroughs of this. What could we do? I think I've got an idea. So today on Codenames, I want to try something a little bit differently. I feel like it's been done a few times. So I figured I'd bring real agents in the field and we're going to shoot from these two windows. Have Red Team up there. Shay will be the Codename Spy Master on Red Team. And then Brett will be the Spy Master on the Blue Team, who is not in the window. There he is, there's Brett, awesome. So Brett is going first, so they will have to have 9 guesses for agents. And then Shay will be going second. She'll have to do 8. The first to get done will be the victor. We're gonna have 2 teams, Dave and myself over there, and Amy and Nathan up on that side.
Let's do water 1.
You just gave us the clue. He said water 1.
Stream. I think it's
stream.
Because, you know, that's usually water and coaster streams, I think.
Yeah.
Right.
We're going to pick stream.
Ooh, 1 point for y'all.
All right, Red Team.
So it's our turn now, huh?
Yankees 3.
Wow. Okay, what do you want to do first? You want to go to New York? So we're going to New York first. Okay. You want to do field next?
Yeah.
All right, let's flip field. Yeah, okay. And then you want to do cap? We're going to switch it from cap. We're going stadium, flip that thing. Yes.
Yay!
All right. We're done guessing. Your guys' turn. Who's going to lose?
Screw this up.
Wow.
So we're going to try profession 2.
Profession 2.
Scientist.
Yeah, we're going to pick scientist. No, we're going to do bank.
Flipping bank, you said?
Yes.
Ooh, what? Is your turn over and we got another point? Okay, what's our guess for like Shay 9?
Accessories 2.
Accessories. You can accessorize with shoes, right? What do you think? Accessory. You want to go shoe first?
I think she's right on shoe.
Oh man, I don't feel good about this. Let's do shoe. Ooh, I feel great. I was always very confident the whole time. So then another accessory. All right, let's do cap. Yep.
Yes.
Ooh. All right, we're done guessing, guys.
Okay. Right. Clue.
Rugby 2.
You want to do Europe?
We're going to do Europe.
Alright, you said 2, so...
2... He probably gave us a note so we can do the profession. You want to be superhero?
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to pick superhero 2.
And just so you're aware of the rules, you can do 2 plus 1.
Yeah.
And we're going to pick pass as well. Okay, now we're done.
What was the clue?
Yeah.
Rugby, two.
Jeez.
Roll, one.
It's roll, one. Oh, dice. It's got to be dice, roll right? Dice.
What else would you roll?
It's got to be dice. Flip dice. Dice is nice. That's what I always say. So we're done, guys.
Halloween, three.
Pumpkin.
We're going to do pumpkin. Okay, we're going to pick rabbit. Okay, we're going to pick dress. How many more guesses
are there? One more.
And
we could win.
We could win.
Oh.
Oh,
you keep saying princess.
I'm going about princess because you can be a princess for Halloween.
It's all or nothing.
Can I do princess?
Let's do princess.
Right? Well, it's either that or we lose.
We're guessing princess.
It's all or nothing. Princess.
That's what you get. They got the black assassin, so they lost automatically. So, yes.
Right. Ryan, your last guess.
Right. Right. Right.
Oh, what the?
Hey, it's just me, man.
Oh, okay.
It's just gaming.
Oh, all right. Well, I guess we'll get to the table and play Codenames.